2010, there were a couple of incidents that just, I just said, okay, I've had enough of this. And I remember going back to my wife and saying, I've had enough of the hypocrisy where nobody's pointing it out. And I started getting more vocal. Of course, we had all these, you know, social media was starting to grow in its infancy, but we started to take off. And I started saying stuff. My wife said, you better look out, they're gonna come after you. And I said, all I said was 2 + 2 = 4. I spoke the truth, that's just truth. But she was right. And I got to a point with my agent, who was a big time agent, I was with a long time, and my manager just said, we can't represent you anymore. I said, why? Well, because you're conservative and you're a Christian and you're, and I was like, what? And I said, this is an industry that screams more than anybody else for tolerance. You have to be tolerant. You have to be, you know, freedom of speech. And now all that stuff is completely a one-way street. It's like, you say what we say or you're out. You're out of the club. Andrew Breitbart said, you know, politics is downstream of culture. Who runs the culture? Hollywood does. Mainstream media does. And you see what's coming out there right now. You see the movies that come out. There's so much hate, anger, divisiveness. Walt Disney said back in the 50s, movies and television will influence the youth. And of course, look what it's doing right now. And there's such an ignorance out there. There's such a, I don't think people are stupid. I don't think young kids are stupid. I think they're just misguided, they're just misled. We got an education system they're telling kids that this is bad and this is good. I never had that when I was in school. I never had that. If I had a math class, they taught math. It was biology, I taught biology. When I got to college, I never had any professors tell me or get angry at me if I had a different viewpoint than them. I have no recollection of any of that stuff going on, but it's changed drastically in the last 15 years. It's just, you know, it's accelerating on itself. And when I usually confront somebody and say, okay, let's talk about that issue. And all they can do is say, you're wrong. You're wrong. Or science, I go, okay, explain the science to me. It's science, and they walk away. Because they don't have the answers. That's where they want to be, because that's where the news people told them they should be, or the industry of Hollywood told them they should be. There's a weird tipping point we're at right now between reality and just fake information. And unfortunately, people are falling into the trap of going for the stuff that's more fake than real. I hope you enjoyed my story, and I'll tell you what, let's keep PragerU going. You can make a tax-deductible donation right now to keep this amazing, amazing website up and running. It's so educational, guys. Check it out and make sure you keep this rocking and rolling. Thank you.